It's election season, as if it ever isn't. So today, on Brief Brain Facts, we're getting a little political and discussing the political brain. If you're ever on social media, you may see people arguing over political affiliation and identity. That's really not surprising, considering that our lives are very political. We rely on politics for our lives and livelihoods. While we all have the shared goals of assuring that our political systems result in a functioning and happy society, it's all about the details. It's those specifics that we fight over. Two main political dichotomies in the US are conservatism and liberalism. But what does it really mean to be conservative or liberal? Conservatism is an ideology that focuses heavily on individual responsibility regarding obtaining basic human necessities, that the government should be limited, and that business and financial institutions should be deregulated. On the other side of the coin is liberalism, which is defined as an ideology that refers to the natural goodness of humans, favoring individual autonomy and a government designed to protect the political and civil liberties of its citizens. Despite popular belief, traits associated with liberalism and conservatism appear to be mostly stable across the lifespan. Both ideologies are marked with behavioral and psychological traits, and these traits accompany their own set of biases and beliefs. According to researchers, you may consider conservatives to be traditionalists. They tend to defer to authority, are resistant to change, and display a general attachment towards established norms and values. Further, conservatism is associated with a general sensitivity towards threats to social order and a willingness to limit liberties in order to maintain that order. In contrast, liberals may be considered progressivists. They tend to adjust their moral understanding based on the situation. Also, they're likely to seek new political and personal experiences, and are more likely to question authority and social norms. According to researchers, liberals tend to underestimate the amount of people who share in their own beliefs, while moderates and conservatives tend to overestimate how many people share in their beliefs. Scientists argue that the perception of in-group similarities are a crucial component in group cohesion. This may account for conservatives and moderates' tendency to follow authority and falling in line, and liberals having more difficulty finding a consensus and more disharmony among group members. Research has shown that political ideology may be driven by emotional factors. For instance, fear is associated with conservatism. As an example, following the 9/11 attacks, a prominent shift towards conservatism was seen throughout the United States. Alternatively, in a study, feelings of safety was temporarily associated with more socially liberal views. But, as suggested, this effect went away. Current politicians argue that one adopts a political ideology due to influencing factors found in one's environment. For instance, conservative politicians believe that liberalism is a product of colleges and universities, and have justified funding cuts to these institutions based on this belief. However, these claims are not widely supported, and researchers have found compelling data suggesting that both liberalism and conservatism may be determined by both society and biologically. For instance, studies involving identical twins who were separated at birth have found a genetic influence on political orientation, meaning that these twins had the same political beliefs despite being raised in different environments. Brain researchers have found that political affiliation may be a result of various structural differences within the brain. Liberalism was associated with a larger anterior cingulate cortex, or ACC, than conservatism. This area of the brain is related to conflict resolution. Among liberals, greater activity was also seen in the ACC when working with conflicting information. So not only is the ACC larger, but also it's more active in the brains of liberals. This may explain liberals' willingness to be open to new experiences, as the ACC may be working to assure flexibility in the face of potential conflict. Conservatism is associated with greater activity in the amygdala, an area of the brain related to fear. Further, this brain region was larger in conservatives than in liberals. This corresponds with a hallmark seen in conservatism throughout decades worth of research, that being a sensitivity to threat and anxiety, especially in the face of uncertainty. I do want to note the brain is plastic, the brain can change. Therefore, outside of twin studies that have shown a genetic predisposition towards political ideology, researchers have yet to determine if people were born liberal or conservative, as their environment may have an impact in shaping these areas of the brain that seem to mediate these two political categories. Also, political ideology tends to be along a continuum, so the two primary categories used within the research discussed aren't perfect. Also, people can have beliefs that are both considered to be conservative or liberal. For instance, one may believe in protecting civil liberties of the people, a typically liberal belief, but also believe in upholding traditional norms and values, a typically conservative belief. Whatever may be the case, liberalism or conservatism is not a mental disorder, but simply a set of values and traits. Have you ever changed your political beliefs or considered doing so? If so, comment below. If you liked what you saw, please subscribe to our channel and make sure to hit that like button. As always, thank you for watching.